I'm going to give you a brief introduction to Google Docs. It's a word processing software. To get to Google Docs, you're going to click on the 9-dot square, then go down to Drive. At this point, I'm going to go into the Practice folder. It's blank right now, and if I want to create a new Google Docs, I'm going to click on New and click on Google Docs. And if I click on that, I'll get a blank document. But before I do, I just want to point out the template option. And there are a number of pre-made templates that you might want to use, and you can scroll down. There are quite a few. And if one suits you, then you can select that and build from that document. So let's create a blank document. Click on New, then Google Docs. The first thing I like to do is change the title. The second thing I want to point out to you is the main reason you would use Google Docs, and that's sharing your document so that you and another person or a set of individuals can work on the same document. So you're going to click on Share here, and you have some options. You can type in the email addresses of people that you want to share this document with, and they will get a message, or you can click on Get a Shareable Link. At this point, you can decide whether you just want people to view that document or comment on it, or they can actually edit the document. So let's pick Edit. If I click on Copy Link, I can then paste that link into an email or a web page and have people click on it if they want to edit this document. Now you can see here there are some of the basic word processing features that you're probably familiar with. You can choose a font, the size of the font, bold, italics, underline, and you can choose the color of the font. So I've changed the font color and size here, and I want to show you a trick that most people don't know. If I click on this heading anywhere in it, and I click on Paint Format, and click on it once, and then I drag over here, that heading changes to that format. So, and I can keep doing that. So click on Paint Format, and that can save you some time. So let's go through each of these menus, and I'll point out some of the key features that I find useful. So if I click on File, I can download this document and convert it to a Word file if I'd like, or a PDF file, or an e-publication. So that's pretty useful. The other thing I can do is go down to Page Setup and change the margins, the background color if I'd like. I can put it in Landscape, and I can change the paper size. The last thing I want to show you in the File menu is the version history. So I can actually see the edits of this document as they go along and who edited them. So I can change that if I want. So if I want to go back to this document, say a blank document, I can actually restore to that version. Say someone made some edits and you didn't like them, you can go back to older versions. In the Edit menu, you can undo or press Control Z, and that's pretty useful. And you can also paste and find and replace text if you'd like. The Insert menu allows you to insert an image, so you can upload one from the computer or other areas. You can also insert and create a table just by dragging along and figuring out the dimensions of your table. You can insert a drawing, and that's sort of interesting because you can click on this, create your drawing, save and close, and that drawing will appear in your document. You can insert a chart, a bar, a column, a line, or a pie chart. Horizontal line. You can also insert a link, and I'm going to spend some time on that. To insert a link, you need to find a URL, and I'm just going to paste one right here. Next, you highlight the text, then you can click on Insert Link if you'd like, and then simply paste the link in. That could work. Or you could highlight the words, click on the little link picture, which I find easier, and then press Control V. Next, I'm going to show you the Tools menu. There's some cool features there. You can check spelling. That's not so cool. There's a word count. There's a dictionary. The one thing that's really interesting is you can actually click on voice typing. And if you have a microphone, Google will translate your voice and pretty well into the actual document. So Google will translate your voice into words and type them into the document, and it does a very good job. The last feature I'm going to show you is how to insert a comment so that if you are working on a document with a team, you can highlight some text, insert, and then put a comment in. And that comment and your name will appear on the side here, and they will know. And that comment and your name will appear on the side here. So that's Google Docs. So that's a brief introduction to Google Docs.